Aha! We will pick up this vehicle if it's the last thing we do. Very good. Now raise the vehicle. Very good. Yes. Now drop it on the set. Very good. Hey! Welcome back, everybody. I'm Jade Monkey. We're back here in Rust talking about the Rust console edition. I mean, that was pretty good. Yeah, we're back here in Rust talking about the Rust console edition for the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One. Yes, we are on the PC, but again, we are talking about the console edition and answering the question, or answering what we do know, Rust console edition, when are custom servers? Now, full disclosure, as of filming this, is that a bear? What is going on? Two bears. Okay, great. As of recording this at the end of August 2021 or early September, there's very little that's known about this, and we will show you exactly what we do know. So it doesn't look like it's coming anytime soon as far as like the next month or two. Again, this is speculation. I could be totally wrong. But we do have some more positive news kind of showing you like what the progress is and how they're going to move forward with this. And yeah, that's what this video is all about. So here we go. As you know, there was a dev blog. They were talking about how we're basically here where the red light is, and we're just before testing branch in the skin store, and then new content being things like our good old friend Power Surge, or even the tech tree update. So if you want to know what Power Surge is all about real quick, I will go ahead and link that video now in the upper right hand corner. And again, giving you a fantastic heads up before it comes through, so you'll be like, man, we are so much further ahead than everybody else. You'll be like, we got you. All right, so here's what we know. So through the dev blog, they were talking about the current status of this, and I'll kind of pick and choose some pieces out of here. Again, we'll try to make this as short as possible. So they said timing of custom server release. So logically, the next question is when custom servers? A lot of work has been done on official servers to improve stability, and the infrastructure has been working for some time internally. So that's good. It's not like it's totally on stop or anything. Says we know how important community servers are to people, so what's the holdup? And first they talk about the cost and how they're trying to keep it down, and the fact that they need to have the memory at a certain level because that's the biggest cost. And then there's also saying where they want the memory ceiling to be, so they are of a good price. There will be people that do the server farms, but they will be hosting it, so everything will be done inside of the game itself. Unlike here, I mean, I guess you can do some of the admin stuff here, like, look, we're on the PC, so I've got stuff like this. And you know, different like menus and stuff. So we'll have something similar to this, but I think we'll have some more admin tools built in for the server itself. Because I actually have to go to a web client to tab out of here and show, you know, what's what. But anyways, so yeah, that's cool. So the fact that it's all going to be integrated into the game is going to be pretty sweet. Oh, you know what? I should also say real quick. As soon as these do hit us over on the console edition, the Boyfriend Squad, Razortube, myself, Jade Monkey, and BioLaser will be running our own custom servers as well. An event server and also some tweak servers that are like solo, duos kind of thing. We're going to try to run some stuff like that, so be on the lookout for that when that does come through. So you've seen us do some arena builds here on the PC, so we're going to be doing stuff just like that over on the console edition, which will be awesome. We'll be also, we'll also be live streaming it. Jeez, am I having a stroke? Am I okay? So, okay, technical support, and they also said they needed to make sure that servers unofficial were in a good place before they started to focus on this. So basically no official word. It looks like they've got their hand on it, and they've been working on it, and it looks like it's coming along. It just looks like maybe we need some memory. And they also said, it's right here. Good news is the public test branch will again help us test performance of different server configurations, maybe even free gun servers again. Just saying. Those were cool during the beta. And it says, well, at least the evaluation of server hardware needs was a lot more positive than expected. Our designers had an extra time to consider the admin and configuration options, taking into account all the community feedback. So again, it looks like any kind of those restricted team size servers will come in with community servers. As you know, as I just said, we'll be doing it for our community as well. So, you know, be on the lookout for those, because I know that's going to be a big deal. And we'll just kind of hit through some of this. We know the demand is high for team size restricted servers. This is not a supported mode given the nature of Rust gameplay. Currently, the official team size is limited to 8 within the gameplay, and simply reducing that to 2 or 3 will not stop teaming up methods. outside of the game. A non-console version of Rust, dedicated admins enforce this rule via moderation and community servers. We're expecting the server type will be very popular and common once custom servers are released. So basically, that type of gameplay will have to be offloaded onto the custom server. So it looks like these will have to be first. They'll have to brew for a while, so most likely we'll get the new content, and most likely we'll see custom servers after that. And as far as like the timetable, we really don't know. I wouldn't expect it anytime soon, to be perfectly honest. I would say if we're lucky, we would get it a month, maybe 2 months, but again, that's a huge guess. Like there's so many variables here we have to see. They have to give us an update on how these memory constraints are working for us. We have to get on the testing branch to see how those different things are actually functioning, and then I think we'll have a better idea or guesstimation of when these will come. So I would say much later, probably, you know, towards the end of the year is my guess. Again, that could very well change. Like the next day they'll be like, hey, surprise, we're gonna bring them out. So again, take that with a huge grain of salt at the moment. And so yeah, we're just gonna have to wait and see. So that's what we know so far with custom servers. I'm sorry it's not anything more earth-shattering than this, but I know we get this question all the time, so we thought we'd make it into a video. So we can also help answer that question, so we don't have to answer it all the time we're on a live stream, which you may or may not have come from a live stream right now. By the way, if you are watching this, see if we are live streaming. Come by and say hi and say what's up. All right, so yeah, that's all we have right now for custom servers. Again, as we get more info, we'll let you guys know. If you found this useful and helpful, be sure to drop a like, and if you're not already subscribed, consider, as we do live stream and release a lot of videos. So come check us out, and we'll see you in the next one. Love you. Bye. Yeah!